In this lesson, let's talk about how to move, rotate, and scale. And in order to move, we need to create something that we will move, rotate, and scale. Here we activate Edit by clicking on T, for example. Here we have the same hotkeys as in 3ds Max. These are W, E, R, and of course Q, which is responsible for drawing. Now we go to move by pressing W, and there is an icon here. This is Gizmo right now. Switches to the classic look that ZBrush has always had. It's Y. Now we need to convert Make Polymesh 3D to demonstrate this. Go, for example, to Move, create such a controller. It's also a quite convenient type of movement. It differs, even differs greatly from the controllers that are in other 3D packages. Switching here by pressing Y, we get a more convenient, one might say a controller that allows us to do all the same rotation, scaling, and moving. So, if for example we want to scale proportionally, then we click here on this little yellow box. If we want to move along some axes, then we just bring the cursor on and do it. I will turn on the floor grid so that we have an idea where we have the plane. We can rotate in this way, and we can move the object perpendicular to the view, or rotate it perpendicular to the view. Everything else will happen along the axis. This is also a very convenient feature. If we want to correct Gizmo, that is to align along this object or make it perpendicular, you can click on this lock or temporarily open it by holding Alt and rotate the axis as needed. For example, like this, we release Alt, it locks. What other features are there? How to rotate, this is understandable. Here you can still scale. For example, I want to scale like this and crop this shape at the corners. For example, like this. I hold down Ctrl and move the cursor while holding Ctrl. If I want to crop from this side, then I hold down Ctrl and in the same way I move the cursor. That's what we will get. The same applies to other axes. If we want to change the geometry somehow here by clicking on the gear, first we have the type of transformation. Therefore, we can choose some kind of primitive. And below, we can apply, for example, taper to an existing current object. This is the usual modifier, which is in all 3D editors. we click on this transparent gear, you can accept this. By pressing Ctrl Z, you can cancel. And we use taper, for example, clicked here. You may not click on accept. Just go to gizmo or back to taper. Now I click here and just make reset, for example. Then return into gizmo. And for example, I'll take deformation. Now all nodes are selected. And we can separately select these nodes and edit them. If we need a certain number of nodes, then we just hold Ctrl and remove, for example, these nodes and work, for example, with the rest of the nodes, transferring them like that. Or hold Ctrl Alt and thus select only those nodes that need to be left. That is, with Ctrl we dropped all the selected nodes in this way, then pressed and held Ctrl Alt, and then selected the ones we need. And now, for example, we can transfer these three verticals along the X-axis. Suppose these nodes are not required. Hold Ctrl and create a frame somewhere in the empty space, then press Ctrl Alt. Therefore, we moved, or rather, we scaled these three pics. Then you can transfer them. And after that, if we're satisfied with this result, we just click Accept, which confirms our actions. Now you can temporarily press Alt, and thereby, this lock is unlocked. Or you can click here and move Gizmo to the right place. In this case, know that the controller move rotate scale becomes perpendicular to the normals. And it is very convenient. The on-off hotkey for this lock is Alt-Tab. Just like in any program, you can rotate either Gizmo itself or the object itself with Shift held down, which allows you to rotate in increments of 5 degrees. In the same way, unlocking Gizmo, we can hold Shift during rotation and see that Gizmo will also rotate in increments of 5 degrees. And you can. Now I'll block it. And all that I've changed, it's possible to. I only had to unlock it. Here, for example, if I want to put pivot perpendicularly to the view, this is done by pressing this button. If you click on this house, we will see that this, our pivot, our controller, will be moved along the X and Y, will be moved to the center, or rather, to zero. If you click on this button, then, as you can see, the object, or rather the controller, will be transferred to the center of the geometry. Here, this button helps us to block the controller move rotate scale in order to, for example, if we will press and hold Ctrl and start moving it, it will be copied, and copying will be in the current subtool. If we look, that is, the geometry will remain, and for example, we hold Ctrl, copy, and press 1, then copying will occur. There will be a repeat of the action, but it will not turn out exactly as what we need. We have to hold Ctrl, or rather, activate sticky mode first. Hold Ctrl, pull, and then press 1 on the keyboard. This will allow you to copy the geometry at equal intervals. And later on, since Gizmo remains here, in the center you can rotate the object. That means the center of rotation remains. What happens is that we just drag and drop an object while the controller remains in place.